Mrs. Truly, one of my happiest days. Finally, I've managed to capture the Pretender King. That's you, isn't it? The one who fashions himself a king? Isn't that what you've been telling people? Forcing them to submit to you? Oh yeah, that's you, all right. I'm glad that you're starting to wake up, because I have a lot of things planned for you. You see, we are in a very special room. My playroom. Don't be fooled by the look of the place. Nothing you will encounter here will be soft. Oh no, quite the opposite. You see, not at all.
Quite the opposite, in fact.
So, what do we do with
Pretender Kings?
Pretender Kings that taunt me. Pretender Kings that take away
my people.
Pretender kings that undermine my rule.
Pretender kings
that have been harassing me for weeks, months. All those messages, all those comments, hearing from people what you said to them, what you said to them about me. Unacceptable. So what do
we do to you?
Well, there's only one thing, really, and that is for you to suffer for what you did. Normally I'm more composed, but today, finally having you in my grasp, it is quite exciting. Oh, you thought your identity was hidden? That you could stay anonymous? No, 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 no.
You forget who you are dealing with.
I am Maria Vanderhoff, Prince of Amsterdam. The ruler of the Camarilla in this city and beyond. And I will take no shit from someone as pathetic as you, so you shall suffer.
But it proved to be those rats
squatting down in the sewers, that we're able to obtain information about you. They are disgusting little things, but they have their uses. And so do you. You'll be my entertainment for tonight. I thought so much about what I would do to you. What I would do to you once I finally had you right where I wanted you.
What I would do to you when you were all tied up, defenseless. When I could do anything I wanted.
Oh yes, I had many fantasies. I would slowly burn you alive, or just tear you limb from limb. I even considered finding your loved ones and torture and defile their bodies right in front of you. But no. Like I said, I truly find you pathetic in every single way. But I do want to make an example out of you. So I'm going to be using one of the simplest tools in the box. Can you guess what it is? Can you guess what simple little tool I will use to torture you? That's right. Just a simple scissors, little rusty, not that sharp, so we're really going to have to work at cutting off all those pieces. That's fitting, isn't it? You who think yourself so mighty, so powerful, to be undone by something so ordinary, mundane, because that is what you truly are, a nobody, and soon nobody will even remember your name. Nobody will care about what I did to you this very night. You'll be just a vague, annoying memory in the back of some fool's mind. So, let's see. No. Oh, yes, now you're scared, aren't you? I don't give a fuck. Yes, give me your hand. I'm going to cut off all those little fingers of yours one by one. Let's see. Yes. You can squirm as much as you want to, but it won't stop me. You are a little tough. Don't you worry. I'm tougher. How does that feel? Judging by the screaming, not very good. Let's move on to the other side. You wouldn't want your other little pinky to get jealous. I haven't been this excited in a long time. Blood you could stand to lose before you bleed out all over my floor, huh? It smells so good. Shall we? Kiss it all better. Don't you worry, you're gonna die before this night is done. And while seeing you suffer has been so much fun, I think I'm finally going to indulge. And just drain you until there's nothing left but a lifeless husk. The lifeless husk of a pathetic pretender king. Victory tastes so good. So good. Mm. onto my floor. Let this be the end. I have to pretend a king.